Hello, Rev John Musson here. Welcome back to learning, whether you're still at home or in school. Hopefully before long, we'll all be back together in the school building. Did you have a good half term? Lots of fun in the snow, and now in the sun. Wonder if you enjoyed pancakes last Tuesday? I did. Wonder what toppings you had on yours? Mine was lots of honey and some lemon. Do you know the proper name for Pancake Day? It's Shrove Tuesday, the day before Ash Wednesday, the day that marks the beginning of the Christian season of Lent, and that's something we'll be thinking about in our worship today. I've already got my candle lit behind me, but wherever you are, if you're able to, why not light a candle now? The Lord is here, the Lord is with us. So, last week, as well as Pancake Day, Shrove Tuesday, it was Ash Wednesday. I wonder what you can find out about those 2 days. Shrove is an old English word that means having all the wrong things that we do forgiven. And Ash Wednesday is the day when we usually have special church services, where we receive the sign of the cross on our foreheads in ash. Ash made from last year's palm crosses. Here's some ash that I made for our service. And I'm going to mark myself on my forehead with a cross now, as I did on Wednesday. When I do so, I normally say special words that remind us of how I'm human, I do things wrong, and ask God to help me to stop doing them, and that Jesus forgives me because of his death on the cross. Which brings us neatly to Lent. Lent lasts 40 days. That's like between now and the end of term, just before Easter. Why 40 days? Because after Jesus was baptized by his cousin John, he was sent by God into the desert. Here's what happened.
This is Jesus,
hey-o!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus was born in Bethlehem and grew up in Nazareth, where he grew in wisdom and favor with God and man.
Oh, I see.
Jesus was baptized by John, and God showed John that Jesus was his chosen one. Then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the wilderness among the wild animals.
Oh, hello, friend.
For 40 days and 40 nights, Jesus didn't eat anything. So he was hungry. Satan came to him and said,
"Hey,
if you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread." Jesus knew God's word, and so he answered, "No. The word of God says people don't live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God." And so Jesus passed the first test. Then Satan took him to Jerusalem and said, "If you are the Son of God, jump off.
Aww.
For the word of God says he will order his angels to protect you, and they will hold you up with their hands so you won't even hurt your foot on a stone."
Wait.
But Jesus said, "The word of God also says, you must not test the Lord your God."
Now.
And so Jesus passed the second test. So Satan took him to the peak of a high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and all their glory. Satan said, "I will give it all to you if you kneel down and worship me." But Jesus said, "Get out of here, Satan, for the word of God says, you must worship the Lord your God and serve only him." Then Satan went away, and angels came and took care of Jesus. And so Jesus passed the third and last test.
Christians use this special time of Lent to slow down. It's what the word Lent means. Some people give up things for Lent like chocolate or cake. Well, I'm not sure about that. But instead this year, I've been encouraging people to take up things instead. Challenge each other to read the Bible more, spending time in prayer, or loving ourselves through Lent by being kind to ourselves, maybe spending an hour doing something we enjoy. And there's a special church page on the website too, with more information. Maybe the things there you might join in with. But you might say, I don't have time. And that's where the giving up something might help. Maybe watching less TV, or time on the computer playing games or chatting with friends. And using that time to grow closer to Jesus and asking God, as Jesus did, to resist being tempted to do wrong things and to think wrong thoughts. I've been baking today and made these scones. I've made them for me and Mrs. Musson to enjoy later with a cup of tea. They do smell lovely. And I know they're going to taste great too. No one will notice if I eat one now, will they? Well, maybe not. But sometimes it's hard to resist temptation. But with God's help and following Jesus' example, we can try. And here's a prayer. Why not say amen at the end if you agree? Let us pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for the time you spent in the desert resisting temptation. In this season of Lent, help us to make good choices too, and to grow closer to you. Thank you for our school community. As we begin this half term, help us to learn from each other and to learn from you. Amen. Our song today is one we haven't sung for a while. Remember, I said the word Lent means slow. The song is Be Still, for the presence of the Lord, the Holy One, is here. We sometimes need to be still to enjoy the presence of the Lord Jesus with us. Thank you for joining in with our worship today. Have a great week. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.